Hello viewers, welcome to another video. Nowadays, brushless DC motor is much more popular than a conventional DC motor. Also, the BLDC motor is much more energy efficient than the AC motors used in most of our appliances. So we'll see what is brushless DC motor, how this BLDC motor works, and we will also study the function of electronic module used for the commutation or the speed control of this electric motor. So first of all, a brushless DC electric motor is an electric motor powered by the direct current voltage supply and commutated electronically instead by the brushes like in the conventional DC motor. So this is basically powered by DC source instead of the AC source. Before jump into how BLDC motor works, let's see the construction of BLDC motor. Like all other motors, it has a stator and a rotor. The BLDC motor can be constructed in different physical configuration. We can have a single phase, two phase or three phase stator BLDC motor. A BLDC motor incorporates a permanent magnet rotor. The number of the poles can vary between 2 to 8 pole pairs with alternate south and north poles depending on the application. Whereas the stator of BLDC motor is made up of stacked steel laminations to carry the windings. Now we have two parts, the windings on the stator and the permanent magnet on the rotor. And also we have two different type of magnets. The first is the permanent magnet on the rotor and the second is an electromagnet on the stator. Now let's talk about some of the fundamental laws of electromagnet. First of all, you can see here, if a current passes through a coil, it will generate a magnetic field around the conductor. So if you hold the coil in such a manner that your fingers are pointing towards the direction of the current, so your thumb will give the direction of the north pole. An electromagnet is produced with north and south poles. Another property of the magnet is, unlike pole attract each other, here you can see south and north pole attract each other, whereas the like poles north-north repel each other. So these are the two properties that will be used in the BLDC motor. Now let's talk about the functionality of this BLDC motor and how this BLDC motor. So this is the simpler model of BLDC motor in which the stator has three coils and rotor has only one pair of magnet. So whenever the stator coils are electrically switched by a supply source, it becomes an electromagnet and start producing a uniform magnetic field in the air gap. So in this figure, we can see that the motor stator is excited based on different switching states. With switching of the windings as high and low signals, the corresponding winding energized as north pole or the south pole. The permanent magnet north pole and south pole align with the stator poles, causing the motor to rotate. Here you can see that this motor produces the north pole, which is used to repel this rotor, whereas this pole produces the south pole, which attracts the rotor north pole. So we normally energizes two poles of the stator at the same time. The one pole is used to attract, whereas the other pole is used to repel the rotor. In this way, the torque of the motor is also increased by energizing two coils of the stator at the same time. Now let's consider the actual model of the motor and see how this motor rotates. So this is the commutation part of the BLDC motor, in which the electronic controller energizes appropriate motor windings by turning the transistor or the other solid state switches to rotate the motor continuously. Also, these are the Hall effect sensors and they are used for the accurate position and the speed feedback. In this way, the electronic controller knows the current position of the motor and it will energize the next pair of the coil in order to rotate the motor. So let's see how this motor works now. Here you can see these are the two magnetic pole pairs on the rotor. We have two north pole and two south pole. So first of all, this is a set of the coil in which one end is the south pole, whereas the other is the north pole. So what happens in this side, this pole will attract the rotor, whereas on this side, this pole will help to repel the rotor in this direction. So in the other instant, the next pair of the stator energizes. This south pole will repel this south pole, whereas this south pole will attract the rotor. Therefore, the rotation of this motor will be in this direction. Similarly, this north pole will try to attract this south pole, whereas this north pole will try to repel this north pole. So these two term poles are also try to rotate the rotor in this rotation. So we'll see another transition in which this pole will be de-energized and this pole will remain energized, and this pole will now energize as south and north poles. And similarly, this south pole will try to repel this and this south pole will try to attract this north pole. Similarly, both these pairs are energized in such a manner as to rotate the motor in this direction. So this is how the signals on these three terminals of the stator motors are switched in order to rotate the motor in either forward or reverse direction, and these are the input signals from the Hall sensors that are received in this microcontroller. So I've explained this electronic circuitry in which we receive the input from the Hall sensors, the microcontroller sends the position and the speed of the motor, generate the corresponding output for all the switches in order to rotate the motor continuously. I hope you clearly understand how the BLDC motor works. For more interesting videos, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.